Hi everyone, today we will look into and develop a hybrid model, LSTM AutoEncoders. This video is based on my original article, Understand and Perform Composite and Standalone LSTM Encoders to Recreate the Sequential Data. So what are AutoEncoders? AutoEncoders is an artificial neural network model that seeks to learn from a compressed representative of the input. Combining feature extraction models with the different types of models has a wide variety of applications. Feature extraction autoencoder models for prediction sequential problems are quite challenging, not because the length of the input can carry, because machine learning algorithms and neural networks are designed to work with fixed length inputs. Another problem with sequential prediction is the temporal ordering of the observations can make it challenging to extract features. Therefore, special predictive models were developed to overcome such challenges. These are called sequential to sequential, and they are widely used. You already have heard of the LSTM models. Now, recurrent neural networks such as the LSTM or long short-term memory network are specially designed to support the sequential data. Now, combining autoencoders with LSTM will allow us to understand the pattern of the sequential data with LSTM, then extract the features with autoencoders to recreate the input sequence. In other words, for a given data set of sequence, an encoder-decoder LSTM is configured to read the input sequence, encode it, and recreate it. The performance of the model is evaluated based on the model's ability to recreate the input sequence. Once the model achieves a desired level of performance in recreating the sequence, the decoder part of the model can be removed, leaving just the encoder model. Now further, this model can be used to encode the input sequences. Let's first create a simple LSTM autoencoder model. Load the libraries. Then we'll create a simple sequential data for input and reshape it into the preferred LSTM input data format, that is the shape of samples, timestamps, and the features. Now we will define the encoder-decoder LSTM architecture that expects input sequence with 9 timestamps and output a sequence with 9 timestamps and 1 feature. For encoder-decoder, input is put together in a single vector. If we want our output to regenerate the same dimensions as the original input, we need to convert this single feature vector 1D to 2D by replicating it by using the repeat vector. Now, let's try the complex one, having one encoder and two decoders. We will name it Composite LSTM autoencoders, where one decoder will be used for reconstruction and another decoder will be used for the prediction. First, the encoder is defined. Then we'll tie up the encoder and the decoders. The workflow of the composite encoder will be something like this. Now, once the autoencoder has been lifted, the decoder is no longer needed and can be removed. We can keep the encoder as a standalone model. The encoder can be then used to transform input sequence to a fixed length encoded vector. We can perform this by creating a new model that has the same inputs as the original model and the outputs directly from the end of the encoder model before the repeat vector layer. We can view each layer by using the model.summary. Now, this standalone encoder model can be used later. However, if we need more than 9 sequences, then we have to increase our sequence length timestamps, else it will overkill the 9 sequence prediction model. That's it. I hope you will find this tutorial useful. Thanks for watching. I have put all the resource links in my description. Bye. See ya.